chase me, bro. Don't chase me. Don't chase me, bro.
I don't believe you.
You killed those people at the temple.
Those people were confused. They were lied to. I didn't want to hurt them. Any one of them could have chosen to come with me. And I'm giving you that choice, son, right now. I would never make you do anything against your will. I'm asking you, please, come with me. Jin is waiting.
Welcome to LOSTies with Jed and Cara. My name is Jed.
I'm Cara.
And it's Easter weekend.
Woo!
And we're out hunting for
eggs.
Easter eggs. Easter eggs of Lost.
Yes.
Are you ready to go find some Easter eggs of Lost?
Yes.
Let's do it.
All right.
Woo! This is a good lift up, babe.
Anna in Indiana says, "Hey Jed and Cara, I found a second mirror moment. This one is with Jin.
He's in the cooler, and you see his reflection in the cooler next to him."
Good observation. Thanks, Anna.
This all seems vaguely familiar. Yeah. Of course. Let's see who it is! From Ryan! Just listen to Donald's latest. Ouch, Jed. No, we're not talking.
Oh, look what you found.
Another one. Mr. Friendly says the title of the package has multiple meanings, referring to Desmond as the physical package. Package of money Jin is delivering, and Jin's baby creating. Oh my.
We did this last year. It wasn't funny then either. That's obvious. Let's see what awesome thing someone wrote. Super Spanx says, "Did you really not know it was April Fool's?" No, just screw. Shit. Where are the eggs?
I think I'm done.
Oh no, we only have a couple left.
No, I'm tired.
Oh no, babe, come on. We can just do a few more and then we're finished.
I'm done!
We're inside now, ready to make some Easter eggs, dying Easter eggs. So you ready for some vidmail there, chica?
Yep.
The package vidmail. Here we go. Vidmail. So first up, I thought since we were a little harsh on the package.
Yes.
I got a few emails here. So imagine on my shoulder is the devil and an angel. And
yeah.
I thought we'd start off with maybe the angel and hear from Scotty Six.
Okay.
Hey, Jed and Cara. Just watched the initial reaction show. Was Jed very angry? Yeah, that wasn't very nice. But we liked the show, did we? Didn't we? Yeah, we liked it. You know, in all seriousness, when you have a baby Jed, you can't get so angry all the time. You're getting to be like Alex. Is he getting to be like Alex? Oh, a little bit. Anyway, I actually liked the package. I thought it was pretty good. I do agree. I don't get the Jin and Sun stuff. Why do we need it unless something big is coming? I think something big is coming with the Flash sideways, so I hope we get it. It was kind of cool to see Kimi again, maybe. It was cool to see Mikhail again, that's for sure, at least I thought. Maybe I'm just too optimistic. Am I too optimistic? Yeah, maybe I should be more pessimistic like everybody else. Anyway, we did love that episode. I think my theory... Oh, hold on, buddy. I think my theory is what a lot of people have said, maybe, although I did have it pretty quick, is that if the Man in Black returns to the X timeline, our normal timeline... No, what? No? Apparently my theory is wrong. Well, I guess we'll have to stay home and think of a new theory for next time. Bye, guys. Say bye-bye.
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 See, little Jake didn't even like his theory.
Shot
it down, decided to go take a nap.
And he gave you fatherhood advice, which I liked. We need more of that.
We've been discussing Jed's anger issues and how it's going to be a problem. Scotty, he's right. We were little Debbie Downers on the episode.
We were.
I've watched it twice, and I gotta admit, I still didn't think it, jumped up in quality. It's still Lost. Lost is a lot better than a lot of stuff on TV. But with that, the fact that Lost has rocked for so long, my expectations are high. And this episode, coming at this time, kind of didn't meet those expectations, I guess. I'm not expecting to have my mind blown every episode, but just some things didn't connect the dots too well. And Scotty actually brought up the Flash sideways and how it kind of...
Yeah.
He wasn't even sure why it was happening. That was one of our big problems. But like Scotty said, more optimism, less pessimism.
It's only going to get better.
And Scotty, we're here making Easter eggs. How much more optimistic can we be? We're colorful, too. See? Okay, so we had Scotty and Jake on this end.
Mm-hmm.
And we got Curtis on this end.
Oh my god, that sucked! That sucked really bad.
And you missed one reflection, Jay. Another black and white episode with Jin in the refrigerator. There was a reflection of Jin off the refrigerator. You missed it. See, you had so much hate going on that you missed a little detail. I betcha when you rewatch this, you're going to catch a couple more things. Granted, it was a total waste of freaking time. They should have pushed forward this story instead of doing build-up after build-up. All that's going to do is piss off a bunch of people and they're going to tune out before the end of the show even comes. And you're right about the pylons. Why couldn't Smokey just grab one of the legs of the pylons and flip the whole damn thing over? No telling what the hell they were thinking. Anyway... I have to stay within my time frame. I just been beat down by my wife, which gave it a C. No, I give it a C, just like you guys, and she gives it a B, because it gave her more information on how Jin ended up in the refrigerator in the first place. Okay? See ya.
Where's your egg holder? I've got
There's
my egg.
There's only one.
That's ridiculous.
You have to share. I'm putting
a red one in. Is that how that's supposed to... That almost fell.
I know.
Oh, shiz. The red is perfect. Those frickin' pylons. He agreed with that.
Yeah.
So again, we've been caught on... We missed that second reflection.
Everyone else caught it.
I was writing notes at that moment, and I think I was scribbling down, love this Kimi scene. It's the problem with taking notes while you're watching it, because you miss little things like that. And I totally did see it second viewing. I was like, oops. Come on, where were you, Jed?
I have no excuse.
Curtis, I mean, I guess we kind of are together in our negativity, but we're positive people. We're optimistic here. And Curtis is optimistic, too. He loves the show. He still gave it a C, so same as us. But...
His wife liked it better, though.
She did, because she got to know more about why Jin was in the freezer.
She was dying to know why he was in the freezer, I guess.
But Curtis did great. Good timing on the video, too, Curtis. And we love hearing from you, man. And I'm right there with you this week.
Yep. Thank you.
Although Scotty gets the little angel. He whispers the good thoughts in my shoulder, in my ear. I'm getting sopping wet here.
That's where I spilled, I think.
I notice. Okay, next up is Methodic John.
Ooh. Hey, Jen Kerr, it's Methodic John calling in about the package. Wasn't the worst, wasn't the best episode. Daniel and Young Jin did a good job as actors, but really couldn't get into this week's episode too much. Maybe it was the story. Maybe it was because I was thinking about The Stand. A lot of great similarities between the Stephen King Stand story and the Lost story. For those out there that haven't read or seen The Stand, I suggest you watch it. There's some great parallels between Men in Black and the character in The Stand, Randall Flagg. There's also another character out there, Trash Can Man. He does have a lot of similarities between Saeed at this time. All in all, you know, it was an okay episode. One thing that I thought was funny, John Locke, I Come in Peace. Dolph Lundgren, there was this movie, Dark Angel, I Come in Peace, You Go in Pieces. Then you have Widmore and Locke there. Couldn't Locke just knock over that tripod? And whoa, skin alert. Man, a little too much. I was embarrassed. That was a little too much. But hey, every actress gets her day, right? Come on, you know. We're no stranger to skin, I guess, on Lost. Great episode. I just like that picture, really. And that V logo. Whoa, God, that was just so annoying that whole time. Very distracting to see that logo. Someone at ABC should get reamed out for that. That's kind of it, guys. Gotta keep it short. Great episode. See you next week. Bye-bye. One last thing. I got a crazy idea that popped into my head. I think because Son got shot in the gut, or baby, we're going to see Juliet appear as her OBGYN. And Juliet, my guess, Jack's ex-wife. He's dating Anna Lucia now, and Sawyer's going to go out on a date and go Dutch with Juliet in the flash sideways. See ya.
M-O-N, that spells annoying
yes.
V logo. We forgot to bring up that stupid V logo.
Yeah.
I was going to make a bit out of it.
That was annoying.
Just got too late. That's stupid. It's still on all the clips that we used this week, too. Punks. Methodic John, first off, amazing that you could put together a video like that on your iPhone again.
Yeah.
Really
that
great
was
stuff.
Cool.
The Stand. Tell him how much I love The Stand.
He loves The Stand. I was forced to read the book. And then forced to watch the movie.
When were you forced to read the book?
Oh, on our honeymoon.
It was sort of prerequisite. You want this marriage to work, you better read this book.
You better read The Stand. Which it was very good, and I will admit.
But the miniseries, too. I was young enough when it came out. I just read the book right before I watched the miniseries, and I love it. I still watch it. I remember when I got the DVD miniseries, I don't know what, it's 6.5 hours long. I watched the entire miniseries, and I watched the entire thing again with commentary. That was just a long day, but
I don't think you should admit that to people.
But Methodic John is correct. With the parallels, there are a ton. Damon Lindelof's been quoted as saying he carries the book around all the time whenever they're doing their planning sessions. They pull out the book. His correlations. One he didn't bring up was Charlie is essentially Larry from the book. Remember Larry the musician? He's always walking around with his guitar. I mean, they basically took that character and made him into Charlie.
Right, that's true.
Yeah, there's just, you should read The Stand. There's a lot of great stuff.
There is a lot of good stuff. Yeah.
And Methodic John, his theory at the end, what do you think of that?
I think that's a pretty good theory. I think that will probably happen.
Yes, I think that's exactly what is going to happen, I bet. I bet we do see that come next week or the week after. I like it all. Like Juliet being the ex of Jack. I like Anna Lucia dating Jack. I mean, all that coming together, I think, will be very interesting.
Yeah. Well, didn't we say they all were going to meet up in the hospital?
Yeah.
Claire, Kate.
Hopefully it's good. Yeah. Claire's going to be in the same room with Son, recovering. Anna.
Right, right.
Awesome stuff, Methodic John. Thank you.
Yeah, thanks.
Next, Stola. We've got Sonny on the phone. Sonny called.
Hey, Jed and Cara. It's me, Sonny, from Massachusetts. I like to say I quite like this episode. I have to say I haven't liked a Son episode in a long time. Maybe from, like, season one. I find it more enjoyable than Recon was. I know this little part, the Kimi was the best part out of all of it. Mikhail getting shot in the eye. That was awesome. I don't know, a lot of the island stuff was pretty cool. I want to know why Desmond's there, you know, there's so much. Oh, yeah, Desmond, he's back. Desmond, he's probably my favorite character. And I don't know what's going to happen. Hopefully we get closure with Sutton and Jen. I don't know. Hope you guys have a nice weekend. Bye.
Thank you, Sonny. Good stuff. Hey, you know, let's talk Desmond for a second. Okay, Curtis's devil is popping up and the horns are coming out. So, Widmore ripped him out of the hospital, out of Penny's arms, pulled Charlie away from him, and has brought him to the island. Just as a storytelling, what ending is going to be satisfying for you, for Desmond?
Getting back with Penny.
Yeah.
And his family.
It's not going to happen. Because we've already seen it happen in season 5.
It's true.
You know, they may have some sort of crazy ace up their sleeve. Because Desmond had that episode, Flashes Before Your Eyes. Where, in theory, he was flashing back in time with himself. You know, when he when he met Miss Hawking. They might have some crazy ace up their sleeve that time got reset, that he went to the alternate timeline or whatever. I'm not sure. I'm going to be disappointed if poor Desmond ends his life on the island and we never see Penny again because the actress is on Flash Forward.
And Widmore choosing to take Desmond away from his daughter is pretty horrible. Don't you think?
Yeah, but Widmore never liked Desmond anyways.
Well, that's true,
but he was trying to protect Penny the whole time. I'm just saying, though, as the character arc, it's going to be a bummer of an ending if he ends up just dying, sacrificing himself on the island, which is what it seems like it's going towards.
Right, right.
But anyway, Sonny, he dug the episode. Mikhail getting shot, he really liked that too, so glad you loved it, man. Thanks for
the
phone call.
He's the angel on the
shoulder. He's adding angels. His shoulder's getting heavier.
Uh-oh.
Speaking of positivity, we positively love Super Spandex and crew. and they're here to tell us why.
And now for the further adventures of Super Spandex.
You ready to do the lost Easter egg hunt of 2010?
Yes!
Today we're going to be searching for bad lost plot holes from the latest episode. Let's go find them. Kendall, you ready? All right, you found one.
Yeah.
What's that one say?
That's a gun plops, like getting hit on the head and having a ninja.
She hits her head and forgets English? We're supposed to buy that?
Come on, let's go find some more.
Come on, let's go find some more.
I found some more.
Why, this episode's chock full of them.
You didn't declare this.
Unimportant scenes about tomatoes.
That's one stubborn tomato. I guess no one told it was supposed to die.
I mean, really, who cares?
Not being married.
No, Mary.
Then we already know that. Hey, Dad. Why are we using plastic bowling pins instead of plastic eggs?
Well, you see, Bella, because they don't make plastic chickens.
You really expect me to believe you?
Well, yeah, you see, Bella, just like in Lost, as long as we point out that something is a bad plot hole, it makes it okay.
Why isn't she speaking English?
She was hit on the head when she was running away from Locke.
Alright, I'm ready to find another, but sure is windy.
At least we don't live in Iowa.
Alright, let's go find some more.
Windmore's paintball guns. I mean, he was supposed to be a super villain. But he's using his wussy paintball guns.
Shh. Not been blue ball.
You've just enjoyed the adventures of Super Spandex.
They mock us.
I think they just mock you.
Remember when Bella said, Iowa, I don't want to go to Iowa?
That's true.
As long as I'm going to live in Iowa.
And then she laughed.
And I asked Spandex about that. She made that up herself. She said that.
But really?
Here's what I have to say about that. I bet she got it from somewhere, didn't she?
I bet she did.
Someone like Mr. Super Spandex himself might be saying crap like that around her.
I bet so.
You influence your daughter quite a bit, sir. Let's take responsibility for that. Here's friggin' Italian.
Children of the day.
hell, Jen? You're messing up my mojo. I'm rocking out here, man! Come on! Let's play! Dude, you're really starting to tick me off. This is the best part! Come on!
That was freaking wicked friggin' Italian. That's we're done. That's our Easter episode. Thought I'd get in here and show you our Easter stuff. Our eggs are looking pretty cool.
Mostly.
Yeah. And we got a few more cooking right here, getting ready. Are you gonna put some happy smile faces on some?
Sure. This one is orange. Didn't work very well.
It's orange?
It's supposed to be orange.
It's a terrible orange. Let's see it. Hold the guy up. I want to see the eyeballs. Don't crack it. Oh, that is very cute, dear. Great job, honey. Whoops, I just zoomed in your boobs. Great job, honey.
Awesome!
Hi there, and welcome to the Peter Griffin Side Boob Hour. A wonderful look back on all the partial nudity network television used to offer. Look at that side boob. Check out this side boob. How about that side boob? That turn you on? Well, it shouldn't, because that's my side boob. Good night, everybody.
Sucks.
That was good.
I don't think yellow is that great. Show blue. Pull blue out. Look at this awesomeness, guys. Whoa!
Woo!
That is like an awesome blue eyeball or Jurassic Park egg. A triceratops.
Robin's egg.
Robin.
What? Just the orange.
You just shot this little guy. Look at that.
He needed some color.
Took the hit.
I'm